Hello students, how are you all? Hope you're staying at home and staying well. So now I'm here with another chapter from your science book, class 8 science book, that is microorganism, friends or foe. Now student, in this chapter we will know about all the different kinds of microorganism. What does the term microorganism means and how they are beneficial to us and how they are harmful to us. So let's get started. Microorganism. What does the term microorganism means? If we split the word microorganism, then it is micro plus organism. Micro means very small. Those organisms are which are very small, they are known as microorganism. Students, if you look around your room, then what type of organisms can you find in this room or in your room? Yeah, your parents are there. You are there and there are some mosquitoes, spiders and there may be some reptiles such as lizards. Okay, but there are some organisms which you cannot see by your eyes. For seeing those organisms, you need special aids or special devices. Those devices may be a simple magnifying glass or a microscope. Those type of organism which we cannot see by our naked eyes means unaided eyes, those type of organisms are called microorganisms. Here we can find this type of organism. See, microorganisms are present everywhere. They are present in your house, they are present in your room, they are even present in your hands, they are present, even they are present inside your body. Yeah, there are many microorganisms which stay or reside in our body. And not only this, in any physical environment, that may be the peaks of mountain, the cold peaks of mountain, or inside the deep oceans, or hot springs, or desert, they are present everywhere. Each and everywhere you can find microorganisms. We have discussed what are microorganisms, where they are found. Now we will discuss about what are the different kinds of microorganisms. There are different types of microorganisms. Broadly, they are classified into 5. First, bacteria. Second, protozoa. Third, algae. Fourth, fungi. And the last one is virus. Now, let us understand each and every type in details in the further slides. Let's begin with bacteria. Now, bacteria are unicellular organism. What does the term unicellular means? Single-celled organism. Secondly, bacteria are prokaryotic cells. Now, what do you mean by prokaryotic? Pro means primitive. Karyotic means the word karyotic comes from the word carrion. Carrion means nucleus. Means bacteria have primitive nucleus. Now what does the term nucleus means? You know that in a cell there is a nucleus where the genetic materials are present. But in case of bacteria, the genetic material is not enclosed within a membrane or there is no well-defined nucleus present in the cell. The genetic material is there, but it may be scattered or it may be present in a part of a cell, but it is not well defined by a membrane. So these type of cells are called prokaryotic cells. Depending upon the shape of the bacteria, they are of 4 types. First one is cocci. Cocci means the shape of the bacteria is spherical. Next, bacillus. Bacillus means the shape of the bacteria is rod-like. This is one of the most common type of bacteria. Third one is spirillum. The shape is spiral. Spiral means it's like entangled shape. And the last one is Vibrio. Vibrio bacteria are comma-shaped bacteria. Let's come to algae. Not all algae are microorganisms. Some of the algae you can see by your unaided eyes. Have you ever noticed that whenever you are traveling by a bus or by a private car, train, then near the village you will see the ponds are covered, like they are the water is covered with a green color layer. What are those? Those are actually algae. That means we can see algae by our unaided eyes. But some of the algae, they are microorganisms. That means they are very small, they are unicellular, and we cannot see by our unaided eyes. Such type of algae example is Chlamydomonas. See, Chlamydomonas are solitary algae, means they remain alone. They do not stay in a group. Next, we have talked about filamentous. Now, some of the algae are filamentous. For example, it is Spirogyra. And some are colonial. Colonial means some of the algae, they are grouped and they stay together. Example is Volvox. So, algae, they may be unicellular or multicellular. They have chlorophyll. That means they are autotrophic. They can prepare their own food. They may be solitary, they may be colonial, or they may be filamentous. They are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means eukaryotic. U means true. Karyotic means carrion. Means they have true nucleus. That means their genetic material is enclosed within a membrane known as nuclear membrane, and they have well-defined nucleus. Secondly, algae, they may be found both in fresh water as well as marine water. That means you can find algae in ponds or lakes and even in oceans or sea. Next in the list is protozoa. Protozoa comes from the term proto means primitive, zoans means animal. They are also called primitive animal. See students, except bacteria, all the other different types of microorganisms are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means they have a well-defined nucleus and it is enclosed within a nuclear membrane. These type of organism, mainly the protozoa, they are unicellular. Unicellular, so they are microscopic. They are aquatic, means they live in water. They may be autotrophic, means they can prepare their own food such as diatoms, or they may be heterotrophic. It is in case of paramecium, then amoeba. So student, you know about amoeba. Do you remember the shape of amoeba? Do amoeba have a well-defined shape? No. Amoeba is a protozoa and it does not have a well-defined shape. Another example is paramecium. If you see in the picture, the shape of the paramecium is like slippers. So, protozoa may have different types of shapes. Next is fungi. Fungi are eukaryotic, means they have well-defined nucleus. Now, fungi may be unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular fungi or microscopic fungi, the example is yeast. We cannot see yeast by our unaided eye. They may be filamentous. Filamentous in case of bread molds. And they may be club-shaped in case of mushrooms. Now, mushrooms are the type of fungi which are edible. Edible means those things which you can eat. So, you know mushrooms are not microorganisms. You can see mushroom by your naked eyes. As well as now coming to bread molds. What are bread molds? If you keep a bread for a long period of time in a moist place, and after some days you will find there is a green layer above that bread. What are these? These are actually bread molds. So the type of nutrition what they are having is heterotrophic. Means they take the nutrients from others. Specifically, they are saprotrophs. They get the nutrients from dead and decaying organisms. Last but not the least are virus. Now, there is a debate if that we will consider virus as living or non-living. Does it sound mysterious? Yes, it is. Virus, when they are present outside the human or the living body, then they are dead. And when the moment they enter the body of the host, they become living. Actually, the virus, they do not have a well-defined cell. means they have genetic material, but they do not have different cell organelles. So what they do, whenever they enters the body of the host, they capture the host cell and take their organelles, and that cell behave as an viral cell. See, nowadays one of the most common virus that you all are familiar with is coronavirus. See, I have already given a picture. See, coronavirus, if you see the picture, the mainly some of the virus, they have a protein coating above it. This is known as capsid. And in some cases, there are some protein spikes that you can see in case of coronavirus. Coronavirus, the term corona comes from the word crown. See, the spikes, the protein spikes in the figure, if you see, the protein spikes, they form like a crown. So the name has been given corona. And one more thing, students. Have you ever heard that always we are using the term novel coronavirus? Have you ever thought why the word novel is given? Novel means this strain was not discovered before, or it's a new type of viral strain. So the term novel is given. Understood? And other examples of virus are, they may be bacteriophage, or have you heard about the virus known as HIV? What is the full form of HIV? Human immunodeficiency virus. And one more picture I have given, it is a bacteriophage. See, from the term, you can understand that it is related with bacteria. They have the capability of infecting bacteria. So they are known as bacteriophage. In this video, we have learned about microorganisms. What are microorganisms and their different types? Let us recall that there are 5 different types of microorganisms. They are bacteria, algae, protozoa, fungi and viruses. Now, viruses, they can be considered both living as well as non-living. When they are outside the host body, then they are non-living. The moment they enter the host body, they become living. So, in this video, we have discussed all about the different type of microorganism. In the next video, we will learn about their beneficial effects and how they are harmful to us. So, till then, be at home, stay safe, and I will see you soon again. Bye.